Can you guess what this is? Well, according to Kabul's municipality, it's a public park. But over the years, it's become a wild garbage dump. Amanullah is among those trying to clean it up. I think our city should become clean and nice, he says, and we should change the garbage dumps into green areas. Amanullah and the others working here are paid by U.S. aid agency USAID, which has hired more than 30,000 people to collect trash in Kabul. The program gives Afghans jobs and in the long run hopes to help this city, battered by decades of war and neglect, become cleaner and greener.
People have the jobs, short-term employment, especially the most vulnerable families. And also, at the same time, they do something that's productive for their city.
Kabul's population has exploded from about 1.5 million in 2001 to about 5 million today. And many people just dump their trash wherever they find space.
Take the Kabul River, for instance. For decades, it was used as a dumping ground. And that means the water is dirty and smelly and a health hazard for the people who live here.
The water is contaminated and canals clogged with trash can cause flooding. One look at the garbage trucks at the sanitation department is enough to understand why only a small portion of the city has a functioning trash collection system. In a city of 5 million, we have only 111 trucks, he says. A growing population and bad, muddy roads mean we can't clean Kabul in a proper way. USAID wants to hire more workers like Amanullah and, in the long run, establish a working trash management system for the whole city. The amount of garbage at this site alone shows there's plenty of work to be done. Fred Pleitgen, CNN, Kabul.